So Jake's got the apron over here and he's been putting these dills on. Got that one on. I was gonna show you the other morning when I was changing air filter. This, I cleaned all the mat off in here. Nice and new looking. Blasted all the oil off of her. Cleaned this piece. Shut the door now. So it's, summer's officially over here, man. It's cold in the morning. I mean cold. Really cold. Chilly willy. I got my Knox Pilates jacket on. I have wore this thing for years now, Knox. I love it. So Jake, let's see, what else, what was he doing? Oh, he's finished, he's got that all welded in. And he got the cracks fixed. Doesn't look like it's cracked again. Somebody was saying about, you know, heat and stuff cracked it, but I want to show you this. See, this is all broke crazy through here. You can't tell me that's from heat. I don't know. We didn't do that. Somebody else did that. It's all broke, so I don't know. Anyway, Jake's taking the Peterbilt and the backhoe up to do some work on a basement. And then he's got to backfill Taylor's basement. Oh, that's cool. Something happened to the grinder there. Broke off the handle. Time for a new one anyway. This is the safety dill. It's all broke. Doesn't work. So I'm gonna go out and rattle around on the cat today. So, wanted to explain why this goes up and down. So, if you've ever seen pictures of the lava flows we have here, like craters of the moon, that's a recent lava flow. I think it's about 2,000 years ago. And so all this ground looks like craters of the moon under here because it's covered in lava. And so at some point a glacier came through, deposited a lot of loose rocks, dirt. The wind blew 10,000 years ago and covered all the rocks with soil. And so when you're digging in here, this is what you find. So you got kind of a trench through here, and then it comes around and drops down really deep. And you'll find places like that. It just goes up and down and up and down everywhere. So I'm hoping that I can get that over in here and really get rid of a lot of rocks in this deep part. I was able to get rid of quite a few in that trench, and I still got a big hole up on the west end there, but most of them are going to have to come this way. And then Matt will just keep digging this way, and hopefully it stays deep and we can get enough hole to get all these in. And then if he keeps going that way, that other big pile, we'll need a lot of hole to get rid of that one. And I think what's going to happen is we're going to be using the 88 and freighting them over to a hole somewhere, because we can't get a hole over next to that big pile of shot rock close enough to be able to just doze them in the hole. We got some hole over there, but not enough. So that's what's gonna have to happen. This is a tough one. Not looking forward to sitting on that cat all day dozing shot rock, but it's what I gotta do. Jeff will win. Oh, so there's the pile from the one hole he dug over there. It's not real big. but hopefully this deepness continues through here. Not exactly sure. That'd be a long way to push it. Even if we get a hole here, I still think we're going to be freighting them over here with the loader to get rid of them. That's quite a pile. So I'm going to get going. Matt will be here later today. It's Saturday.
Okay, before you start calling me a shitty operator, I have to tell you, flying a drone and holding a remote control in your left hand and then shifting and steering with that left hand and not pushing the home button, I crashed it over into the dirt pile there. You probably saw that. So anyway, I got this damn lump right here where they didn't blast it. It's got a hole there, a lump here. I'm trying to go through that. Anyway, just trying to push a few down there to finish filling that. And what I have to do is I push them out like that, scatter a windrow, start over there, and take them on down into there. And I think I got enough hole left over there to get what's left in there, I hope. Because we are really struggling to find enough places to get it buried. It's not like you can dig a straight hole here. Like I was saying early this morning, this underneath of this dirt all looks like the craters of the moon. If you don't know what the craters of the moon is, Google that. Or, you know those videos I made when we were hauling gravel up on the gun range? Go look at those. Look at the giant holes where the lava tubes collapsed and whatever. Well, that's what these are. It's places where the lava was flowing and in a tube collapsed, left a big hole. Glaciers came through, the wind blew. Frank Cunningham lost half his farm. E-I-E-I-O. Blew half a mull hall right here. So we could grow them taters. So you could have taters and gravy down there in Texas. So anyway, do you think that the rest of that'll fit in there? Man, I hope so. I want to be done with this so bad my teeth hurt. Wait a minute, my teeth hurt anyway from banging around on that cat. So I want to show you some ancient relics I found in here. I'm gonna date them probably 200 million years ago, and I have a theory on what they are. I'll show you. You can tell me what you think, but I think these will prove that man's been around a lot longer than 6,000 years. I could be wrong. Anyway, I found two of these. And I've only found one like it before. And I found it up in the hills, up on that runway job. There they are. So I'm guessing this is from the Jurassic period. Some kind of giant flesh-eating horse. But it's obvious cavemen are around because they shoot them. And they probably rode them around. But yeah, I'm serious. I'm serious. Probably a little delirious too out in the sun. Man, I could see my breath this morning. It was so cold. Had a jacket on. Frank, I put on that jacket and I was tempted to go get some Freon and charge my air conditioner. It was cold. And then it got warm. It's probably about 80. So I'm going to shut Killdozer off. And I don't even want to look under there. Look at that. There's no flanges. Oh. You know what? It rides really good now. So it rides really nice without those flanges banging the pin bosses. Serious. I think if I get a new set of rollers, I'll just cut all the flanges off. until some moron their prehistoric horseshoes. Oh, my brain's baked. Mrs. Paydirt and Mr. Griffey went boating today on a houseboat. Can't wait to see some pictures and video from Mama. Anyway, he's got his own Corgi life jacket, because last time they were out in the Snake River, and Tammy was out wakeboarding and she fell off or something. Anyway, he was gonna go rescue her. He just jumped right in the water, and my daughter-in-law had to go save him. So anyway, you guys have an awesome Sunday.